I'm your host, Harrison.
Bang, Najee.
Bang, 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 bang.
Honestly, I think I can fuck with a motherfucker like you.
Ooh,
gee. See, I don't like a motherfucker that be all on this.
It's the 81 and 92 podcast, where we always keep it 100.
Show me one!
You know how we do.
Man, 100.
Ooh, gee. All right, so we had Snowfall just ended recently, and for everybody who did not see it, we about to spoil it for you now. So if you ain't, you waited too goddamn long. But Snowfall came to a six season finale, wrapped it all up, and to me personally, it was one of the best endings of a TV show I've seen. Period. The ending alone vaulted it up to, I mean, The Wire was great, but I feel like the way it ended it.
Calm down.
The Wire was great. But it's up in the top two. So as far as if it was a debate, Snowfall to me is in the top two. But I wanted to get all y'all opinion on the last episode of Snowfall, the series finale, and Snowfall as a whole. How do y'all feel they brought the show together from start to end? Did they do it correctly?
They landed the plane. They did everything they were supposed to do as far as I'm concerned. For a second, I was kind of fucked up because I didn't realize that they were saying that what happened over the course of a number of years. Meaning the decline of Franklin into being a complete fucking dope fiend, but that shit ended great. A great ending to a great show. So shout out to them for that shit.
Yeah, it's crazy that the run was only 7 years from 83 to like 90. All that happened.
If you know anything about the dope game, that was a good fucking run. Yeah. Like the Kingpin era, that's about how long it really lasts for most
Nolly,
Kingpins.
What you know about dope?
Nothing.
Oh, okay. You said nothing about the dope era. If you niggas was alive then when crack was at its peak, you know, everything was great. You know what I'm saying? Shit, niggas was living the time of their lives. We was partying. We was happy. You know.
I witnessed it from my folks' pad. I scribbled it in my notepad and created my life.
I recall saying they weren't even gonna talk.
Right, he just said that shit 2 seconds ago. But
I thought it was gonna be 10 niggas.
No, man. You got to think about like other true stories. You know what I'm saying? Like Paid in Full, the AZ Faison story. His run was only a year and a half. You know what I'm saying? And look where he got to before his downfall. So. 83 to 90, yeah, that was a hell of a run.
I mean, putting if you want to look at it like this, Breaking Bad was a whole, the five seasons only was 2 years of real time. So Walt did all his stuff in 2 years. So for Franklin to have that long of a run and to make that much money and be, you know, on top like that and not die or go to jail in that 7 year span was a hell of a, it was an accomplishment. So he should clap to himself.
And even had control over the plug.
Exactly.
And shit, like, even if you take it to, like, actual real life, you know, not that I know anything about these real life guys or anything, but, like, if you even watch American Gangster, like, and you see the runs of, like, Rayful Edmond or the real Freeway Rick or any of those dudes, most of their run was, like, 6 or 7 years, 5 or 6 years. They made millions of dollars, but it was in a very short span of time.
Right.
Like most of the time you get a real good short run and your ass end up locked up for a long time or dead. Like even you ever see the movie Cocaine Cowboys?
I thought you was about to say Cocaine Bear. I was like, I ain't seen it yet.
Nah, I ain't see that shit yet neither. Don't spoil that for me. But Cocaine Cowboys was set in Miami. Like a lot of them dudes, like they had real short runs. The crazier part of Cocaine Cowboys, it was told from the perspectives of the motherfuckers who actually did it, which those niggas was all out of prison. So shout out to that shit.
And then the other thing I like about it, man, is like for the folks that don't know, it was based on true events. You know what I'm saying? It didn't have a happy ending. You know what I'm saying? It was the realest ending that it could have. Like a lot of motherfuckers tell people when they get in the dope game, like you either gonna end up dead or in jail, or you know what I'm saying, on the street. Where you're gonna end up dying anyway. So yeah, I think it was a, like you said, they landed the plane.
Yeah, because I knew dudes like that, like out of LA, who when we was real little, they was the man. Like I knew a dude, this motherfucker had 4 Corvettes, 2 Mercedes, and a Rolls Royce. Now he's a mailman.
Hey, Dozy. Dozy. It's back in the 70s, huh?
Here we go. It starts. It starts.
I mean, I think the ending was perfect because Franklin got to live in the environment he created. Like, if you remember, go back to season 1 when the cop Andre was like, look, watching how the hood was changed because of what crack did to it. And you know, Franklin being the catalyst for all of that, it was only right that he had to suffer in the, you know, in the environment that he made. And so it was like
he laid in the bed. Yeah.
It was perfect. Like, killing him, going to jail would have been, you know, we've seen that in all the fucking movies. We've seen every bad guy get killed. We've seen everybody, you know, get locked up. But we ain't never seen a motherfucker just suffer in squalor, you know what I'm saying, living in your mama house, you know what I'm saying? This shit was fucking crazy, man.
Hell yeah.
And like I said, I enjoyed the realism of seeing a dude turn into a fiend because I seen kingpins turn into dope fiends. So that's what I like about that shit.
Sexy chocolate nigga like me. Can't keep a bitch.
You've been hearing that all your life. So a real question that I've been wanting to ask one second, Mitch. I've been wanting to ask this. Who was the real reason for Franklin's downfall? So we got Teddy, we got Louie, we got Sissy. Who was the real reason for Franklin's downfall? Who do y'all
Franklin
think?
First. Go ahead. Franklin was the reason for his downfall. Simple as that. Can't blame nobody else for Franklin being fucking stupid. Franklin gave everybody the keys to his house. Everybody knew Franklin business. So they were easy to take him out. You let, Louie meet the plug. You let Veronique have all the fucking info about your accounts. You let Teddy know how much fucking money you had. You let Peaches know about this drop. You gave everybody the damn arrow to damn take you down. So Franklin is the downfall for Franklin. Nobody
else. I'm going second, and I'm blaming Sissy and that mole. Fuck her. It was her fault.
Ready yet? Get set. It's all that.
Elaborate.
That mole been around since The Wire, bro.
But you knew Alvin was fucking dead. Like, you gonna blink that nigga during the drop? You gonna blink that nigga? Like, hey, about to put the password in. Hey, what prison is Alton in? And they look at her like, bitch. Come on, Sissy dropped the ball, man. Worst TV mother in history. I watched that episode of Ozark. Sissy still fucking terrible.
Man, Florida Evans is the worst TV mom, dog. Everybody know Florida Evans is the worst TV mom, dog.
First off, Florida Evans could not help that she ain't had no neck. Ozark, Marty's wife was getting cracked. Marty's wife was getting cracked, and she took all the money, and she was about to leave him until the Mexicans threw him off the bridge and made his head explode on the street. Don't tell me that Sissy worse than Marty's wife.
Florida Evans was a hater. She handcuffed her kids. Even after she left her kids, was still living in the project. Look at that, man. She wouldn't even let James come up with a good hustle. She'd talk him out of it. Oh, just stay broke, James. Get that unemployment. Now I'm going to head to this pool room and make some money. No, don't do that. She'd talk him out of every motherfucking hustle. I mean, come on, man. Nah, I'm going with Florida Evans' worst TV mom, nigga. Hands down.
We gonna get to that topic after this. I say Louis is to blame. Like, yeah, Franklin let everybody in the crib, but Louis had ill intent from the moment she wanted to separate from Franklin. You know what I'm saying? And then he wasn't her blood, so she really didn't give a fuck about him from the jump. You know what I'm saying?
I think it was his obsession with that $75 million. He start making mistakes once that money got locked up, and he was like, nigga, I kill this nigga daddy to get this money. I'll do this. He was exposing himself just to get that motherfucking, like, once that money got locked up, he should have just charged that shit to the game and went another way. Like, all right, I'm gonna have to find another plug, re-up, recruit, and reboot, do a whole nother setup. and just start fresh. But he was so obsessed with getting that money, he did everything that it took to basically hang himself.
Because he ain't had no hustle game.
My bad.
I said, nah, Franklin was smart. He just ain't had no hustle in him. If he was really a hustler, he would have found a way to bounce back, but he ain't had a hustle. He was just real smart. Everybody else was hustlers around him. Everybody else fell off, and they found their way back up. But not Franklin. He want to borrow from a nigga to get back on. That ain't how you do it.
I agree with that. I think we also, I guess a lot of people, I feel like, are overlooking the fact that, like you just said, Dolomite, his obsession or also addiction, you know, I think that just goes past any type of intelligence, any type of hard work. He was addicted to that money. And no matter how smart he was, how conniving and clever, he was always going to fall victim to the money. And because I thought about it, he had a million ways to go back and flip money that $500,000. He could have took that $12,000. I mean, there was so many times he still had Veronique took $800,000 of $1 million. So I mean, he had money, but it was just that 73 that really had him locked in and, in my opinion, addicted. And all of that was just gonna go out the window. He wanted that 73 and then that 37. And then it just kept getting lower and lower. I think somebody pointed that out too. Started with 73, then 37, then whatever Veronique left him with, and then 12,000, and then all the way to when he asking Leon for $10 to go to his old job, chose to get his his.
Like, that nigga said a 20. You the man.
If he was a real nigga, he would have put that 12K for a CDL. And got his trucker's license.
Started his LLC.
Yeah, he started his LLC like everybody else. But you know, that's LLC Twitter. So I guess we can switch it to the next one. Before I ask that, Banks actually had a question as Dolomite. So go ahead and ask him.
Yeah, I know on the last episode you were kind of hinting at the connection that Franklin and Rick Ross have, and I know that's kind of been out there for a while now. I know at one point Rick was supposed to come on as like some sort of creative entity where he was going to guide John, but then, you know, they butted heads at some point. But I know you being from out there, I was curious, like, how much, I guess you would say is connected to Franklin. How close are they connected, I guess, in your opinion, from what you know from the old heads out there?
Damn, niggas had to throw old head in that motherfucker. Tony, you been talking to this nigga? What? Hey,
I'm respectful. I'm talking about people older.
But no, like in reality, it probably was about 65% accurate. Okay. Like, I feel like a whole lot of what they did with it was, we gonna take the origin story of it and then we just gonna build our own shit with it. Because once they start murdering people, that shit went off the rails. Because a lot of what was happening in L.A., a lot of the murders in L.A. was gangbanging. It wasn't, didn't have shit to do with the dope game. Because when Rick Ross,
I don't know about that.
So the raping niggas was real.
You know, that was some job.
Gangbanging only came. The gangbanging was, it didn't get dangerous until the drug gang came.
No, it didn't get dangerous until the drug gang brought all the guns. Once niggas' weapons started upgrading, and it was like, why would I whoop your ass and I got a Uzi? Why would I get into a fight with a motherfucker and I got an AK-47? So it wasn't like, the dope money. But that's what I'm saying. Like, the dope money brought the guns, but it wasn't like we was shooting niggas over murder. Like, niggas was getting killed, and they'd have all their jewelry on them after they died. Like, it wasn't like niggas, oh, I'm gonna rob this nigga to take all his dope. Niggas will blow your brains out and you'll have a trunk full of kilos, and niggas wouldn't touch that shit. Like, gangbanging was gangbanging. It didn't have shit to do with the dope gang. Like, a lot of motherfuckers had a surplus of cash, so it was like, nigga, if we gonna kill each other, we gonna kill each other. I ain't got shit to do with what the fuck is in your trunk, what's in your stash house. Like, niggas got robbed by broke niggas. Niggas wasn't getting robbed by gangbangers. So a lot of what was happening out here as far as the murders, it was completely gang-related. It didn't have shit to do with this drug dealer's trying to get over on this drug dealer, because he was plugging both sides. Pause. Like, when Rick Ross was serving dope, it was like, nigga, the Crips get just as much as the Bloods get. So it's no like, oh nigga, we gotta go and rob them Compton niggas. Like, no, you don't. Everybody got dope. Anybody getting robbed is getting robbed by a fiend or just some rogue, broke ass nigga who sees somebody doing too much and slipping. But as far as the story, it's probably 65% accurate.
So
that nigga, like, that nigga know Banks. He was there. He lived this. He, I fuck sissy, bro. He said,
"Yeah, man. she had that ass." The season finale of the last season when she was walking out in Puerto Rico with that dress on, it was some movement back there.
She was clapping, nigga. That shit was clapping.
She had that ass. Sissy got that ass.
She get a pass for me just for that.
Them fed cheeks. I don't want that.
Florida Evans, worst mom, Skylar, Marty wife, those three, you know what I'm saying?
I agree with John. Florida Evans take it as worst mom.
Yeah.
She didn't prepare her kids.
Where did JJ get all this cash? Where did he get all this cash?
I wouldn't call her the worst mom. She was afraid of progress. She didn't want her children doing anything that was out of the normal. Like, she was every terrible stereotype mammy possible. Which was so terrible because
she wanted them niggas to, she was proud of them projects.
Yeah. And what was so terrible is like the real her, I can't remember her real name, but apparently
that's the role.
She was actually like a rider like for the civil rights and all that stuff. So the fact that she was even playing somebody like that with that type of mindset is crazy.
Crazy what you do when the bills is due. I actually didn't get my villain. I thought Louis was a villain of the entire show. I think if y'all pay attention to Louis, I think if you pay attention to anybody that got involved, Louis was the villain.
Louis, most horrible person on the show.
Louis was the worst person. Anybody that fucked with Louis died.
Can I ask you a question? If I'm Louis and I'm Franklin ain't selling no fucking dope. Louis selling all the fucking dope. So why the fuck I'm cutting you out the fucking way? You ain't doing shit. I'm moving all the product. I done set up shit outside the state and everything. Louis was fucking moving it. How she the villain?
Louis. Okay, first off, Louis left old girl because she wanted to be 1A. Louis left Jerome the first time because she wanted to be 1A or 1B. Louis left old girl again because she wanted to be 1B. Then she got into it with Franklin because she wanted to be 1B. Her ultimate demise when Jerome wanted to stop is because she didn't want to take orders for nobody, which got Jerome killed, she ended up getting old girl killed. So, I mean, like I said, Louis was the ultimate villain because when she wanted to break away, that's when the empire really started to fall.
Nigga, I'm doing all the work.
Hey, Jern, not only did Louis get Jerome killed, she had the nigga from what's the strip club show about Mississippi, Eddie Funeral. She got him exposed too.
I thought I was the only one who saw Uncle Clifford. I was just like, bro, what type of branding shit is this? Everybody got it.
What Uncle Clifford doing at Jerome Funeral, man? Jerome still
rocking. Because she know Wanda. Because she know fucking goddamn Wanda. That's why. The damn.
He gonna fuck around and be in the spinoff.
And then on top of that whole shit with Kane was Louis' fault. So what's up, everybody? It's summer time. Almost. But it is time to beat the heat, and why not do it with something sweet? Icebox Italian Ice is a frozen dessert that lets you just do that, chill out, dig, get some shade, and eat something, maybe your favorite flavor like mine, which is lemonade. Order right now at ItalianIce.com. Head over there right now and get a delivery today. You can also make sure you follow them at their IG at Icebox615. This is one of the best Italian ice spots located in Nashville, Tennessee. So head over there right now and get you something today. Peace.
Louis definitely the victim. Yeah. Villain of the show.
Louis the villain of all this shit.
Kane robbed Franklin because Franklin wasn't showing no respect, correct?
Kane robbed Franklin because Franklin killed his brother.
Right.
And then when Franklin was trying to rectify the situation,
he ain't pay him for it or nothing.
Franklin was trying to rectify it, Louis put a hit out on the nigga and the nigga lived.
Because then they robbed Louis and shit. They hit a spot up.
No, Franklin hit up Louis' spot at the end because that's when they was playing.
No. When Kane and them hit Louis and them.
Stop trying to take up for her, brother. She the villain.
I'm just saying, like, bro, you trying to absolve Franklin and all of this shit, bro. Like, no, Franklin was the fucking villain, nigga.
Franklin paid some villainous parts, but Franklin also got saved a majority of the time because Franklin didn't even,
But shit, that nigga saved Louis. A lot Kane of what fucked him practice. Up was him trying to save Louis, though.
Jerome killed was trying to save Louis. You forget she was about to get raped by a nigga with a perm.
No, wasn't about to. She for sure got raped.
Nah, she ain't get that far. Clothes just came off.
Kane was hunting Franklin off of that Kevin shit. He was whether the business was falling or succeeding, Kane was gonna come at Franklin. You know what I'm saying? And he thought his Louis spot was fucking with.
And she never took accountability for shit. So that's really why she the villain. Motherfucker ain't learned a goddamn thing. Right. Learn a goddamn thing. Right. Louis the motherfucker. Drop that. Just for that.
So now, real quick, a question to the group. Maybe I missed this. Why did Peaches end up stealing $5 million? Just because he was...
Because he could.
Okay. I thought it was something deeper that I missed, but it just...
He was the only other one with access to the stash house.
Yeah, and he saw opportunity and he took it.
And so I'm going to tell you why Sissy ain't the villain, because the moment she asked Franklin to leave and she seen Franklin was going to turn on his own people to work with the government, which was the opposite of Alton stood for, that's when she decided to shoot that motherfucker.
Only thing is, I just wish she could let that nigga say that password before she shot his ass.
I don't think he was ever gonna get the money.
He wasn't walking away unscathed with that $37 million.
Okay, you got a tortured white man in front of the CIA agent that's supposed to take him.
I just don't know why Sissy was there in the first place. My bad to cut you. I just don't know why he brought his mom. Not to the
She said she wanted to tell him bye.
No, not to the meetup, but to the warehouse or wherever he was holding all these people at. Why am I bringing my mama to this place?
I guess to keep everybody under one roof. But because I know
that's
his
mama.
Yeah, but I know
there was no strategic reason. It's like, that's my mama, dog. Like, it's my mama.
That mole has some power.
A little hole in the storytelling there. A little weak, but
I just don't see a situation where you can hand over a tortured CIA agent, white CIA agent, to another white CIA agent and walk away.
He had the KGB agent tied up.
You handing over a tortured white CIA agent to another white CIA agent.
He had strategic leverage.
Hey, we're not going to act like the main CIA people wasn't about to cut Teddy off anyway. We're not going to act like we wasn't.
Yeah, because remember, he said that. He said, nigga, you ain't even CIA no more, so fuck it.
Let me get this. So where y'all rank Snowfall, and what's the top five shows?
I got it at number one because I never seen The Wire.
I'll second that because I ain't never seen The Wire either.
First of all, you niggas got to log off right now. Y'all got to log off right now.
But I could go binge it right in about a week and then be right where y'all are, right?
No, yeah. It's gonna take you longer than a week.
OG Brown, big homie.
I give. It's somewhere in the top three, wherever you want to put it at in the top three.
What's your top three?
Are you asking shows, period, or drug-related shows?
I said drug-related shows.
Okay.
But, I mean, you can, since it's hard to pick five drug-related shows, you can put shows, period.
It's not really that hard to get five drug-related shows.
I just don't think Narcos is one of my top favorite shows.
I never watched Narcos.
I watched the first three seasons.
Really good. How congruent it was to like actual events and how they weaved it in and out. Narcos was good.
And then if I put Power, I'm gonna have to put the whole universe in there, so which it still makes my top five shows.
No, you don't.
I'm just saying I could put, because the first four seasons of Power up until when they killed Angela was really good. And then BMF is really good. Kanan is really good. So I'm just saying it's not like all of Power.
But that's what I'm saying. I judge them as their own things. Like I look at all the motherfuckers as their own shows. Like
even though the second season of Tyreek was really good, and the second season of Tyreek was really good.
I feel like Tariq,
calling Tariq. We calling the wrong name already, but anyway, are we really calling Tariq's show drug dealing? I mean, I feel like that just happens in the back. I mean, maybe I'm looking at it different. I don't really feel like it's driving the show, but maybe it is.
I just called it Power Universe shows. because I feel like niggas is really down in power because of a bad final season. But the way that they seem like they wrote it, knew that they was going to Tyreek. Like they wrote it as if it was going to be a continuation. But up until Angela, like when Kanan and Tommy and Ghost was working together, that was probably where they should have ended power. Like right when Dre was becoming that bitch, like that's when they should have ended it. Not that last one where they did six episodes of what happened to Ghost. But yeah. I still think, like, niggas forget how good Power was, and that last season just kind of burned people's opinion of it. But like that I said, the first,
it turned exactly. into R. Kelly trapped in the closet.
Exactly. But the first five seasons was really strong.
I don't disagree. Yeah.
It's funny that he uses the term fucking power universe with that Marvel poster over his shoulder. Niggas,
I'm here. I'll put Snowfall at either one or two. It's one and the wire right with it, and then Power.
What? Y'all tripping, bro. Snowfall ain't nowhere near the Wire, dog. Like, nowhere. They're not in the same class at all. Like I'm
what's the difference? What's the difference between The Wire and Snowfall to you?
Okay, who is the main character in The Wire?
You can honestly say it's a bunch of them because they all their characters developed.
No,
Franklin.
The main character in The Wire was the city of Baltimore. Keep going. Okay.
So, well, I mean,
it showed the ever changing different sides, like every season was something different. First season,
that shit too deep, man.
Again, get out that water. You can't swim, young man. Y'all young people can't swim. You know what I'm saying? Y'all young boys don't know how to swim.
That nigga older than me.
I ain't
trying to divert the energy and nothing, but that nigga older than me.
That nigga younger than you, but he look older than you. These young niggas, man, they just be aging like spoiled milk and
that,
shit.
Yeah, that I did think Tony was like 45 when he
I thought this nigga worked for the city or some shit like that. I thought that nigga was like the garbage man in his town or some shit like that. That nigga like he worked for waste management or some shit, nigga.
That nigga said you got grass stains on your shirt.
Y'all got an SSI meeting after this or something? What's up?
No, sir.
Hey, look. Because he kept saying Florida, like, you know, that nigga was, he was in there. My bad. I respect my elder.
He was watching that shit every week.
Yeah, for real. King German. Name makes sense. That's a biblical name. You got that shit back there.
You know, German in the Bible. Where that's it?
God damn it. Right. German in the Bible?
When everybody was born, they were just handing out King Leroy.
That nigga name could have been King Tramiel, and he'd be like, yeah, that shit was in the Bible.
But God damn. To go with the old dude, The Wire definitely the best. That's it. It's the best. The Wire the best. But Snowfall is second.
No, Snowfall not even better than Breaking Bad.
Breaking Bad is overrated as fuck.
No, it's not. Just say you ain't.
I mean, you don't even fuck with Meth. You ain't never seen nobody fuck with Meth. None of that. I don't fuck with crack either.
So you fuck with crack. Oh, you fuck with crack. Okay, go ahead. Keep going.
I don't fuck with crack, but I know.
How could you put Snowfall over that? You must fuck with crack. By your own logic, you smoke crack. You smoke crack, don't you?
Do you know what crack is?
I'm not even finna.
Nigga, I'm old. I'm gonna wait till this shit is over
to say what I was gonna say. I'm gonna wait till this shit is over because I don't want to record it.
Now? I know a lot of meth heads now. Yes.
That nigga
meth is a new drug. It's not now
that crack is gone. It's niggas taking meth. Unfortunately, yes.
Y'all niggas is doing Molly. That's meth. That ain't no Molly. That's meth. They ain't never crushed up meth that y'all niggas doing that shit. And they tricked y'all into
drugs. Drugs the way to be.
Yeah,
you're right.
I'm a every Sunday.
I don't do
drugs. Your lame ass up, nigga. I ain't got my Dare shirt on, nigga. We ain't talking about that shit. Go ahead.
Damn, actually, he has an A More than 92 shirt on. Damn, that's fucked up. Yeah, damn, just shit on your own merch.
Take that shit out, bitch.
Right. Just shit on your own merch. Damn.
Yeah, take that shit out right now. I'll take that shit off on air.
Yeah, nigga, just shit on his own merch, dog.
Keep the fear of God.
It's original too.
Tell me like, that shit got make you itch and shit. That's
it's original. Cover it up.
We're going to cover this up.
And nigga muted himself, stupid ass.
Nigga, yeah, you on mute talking shit. God damn.
You got his
overproducing ass nigga.
You got his limited run hoodie on. Appreciate that. Yeah, support always.
Overproducing.
That's crazy as fuck.
I got on a regular camo hoodie.
Man.
So you got Snowfall over the Sopranos too, I take it.
That's another one I never dived into.
Shout out to niggas who watch a lot of TV.
Yeah, bro, I ain't watch that shit. I ain't Italian.
That's we're not gonna no Germ, don't even fall for it. No,
nigga, yeah. I'm Germ.
You ain't no superhero either, nigga.
Germ, I'm trying my hardest to hold this information back, Germ. So I'm gonna wait till we finish recording.
That nigga think he's from Asgard or some shit, nigga. You ain't from Gotham City, motherfucker. What the fuck?
You lucky my shield.
Oh, you from Wakanda, you Wakanda, nigga. That's what you is, right?
Lucky I can't reach that shit right now, nigga.
Oh, I put my address up. I'm gonna put my address up here, then, nigga. What you talking about?
Here we go. Here we go. Because you know my nigga, Harrison will drop the low.
This nigga got the real hammer. He can't even lift that shit. You ain't worthy, nigga. You ain't worthy.
You know how I know this nigga's a geek? This nigga is a dork, dog.
He's not worthy.
That nigga got some Pokemon cards on the side too. The niggas over there flipping them little circle little disc thing. What the little young kids used to do? What that shit was called? Battle gourds or battle bonds or
Beyblades, nigga.
Gay blades. That's what it's called.
Gay blades.
Yeah, gay blades.
No, I said Beyblades. First off, I know a nigga that played hopscotch and played marbles. Ain't telling a nigga what they did. Any type of games, right? Nigga
played Jax. It was called Jax.
I know you knew. Shit.
We drew a circle on the ground and put the motherfuckers in there.
Don't ever tell us how we used to pass our time.
Our toys ain't have to make noises. We made the noises for our toys.
Hey, you got to cancel them Jax accusations, bro. You ain't play Jax, did you know?
Hell no, I ain't play Jax. Not from Compton.
Hold on, y'all niggas double Dutch, but y'all only play Jax. What kind of fucking world I'm in right now, dog? Like,
nigga, we got to sit next to white people. Nigga, we ain't had to play that bullshit.
You ain't play Jax, but you double Dutch.
Nigga, I don't
understand. We shot marbles.
This nigga Harrison said he double Dutch. I shot
marbles.
Wait. You were double Dutching, bro?
Had a full I knew childhood. How to double Dutch.
Man, I got four sisters, dog.
I'm like...
If you got four sisters, you know how to double Dutch.
I got two. I don't know how to double Dutch.
Four sisters, nigga. I knew how to double Dutch, nigga. Sometimes I had to turn the ropes, nigga.
Hey, I turn the rope all day. I'm not jumping, dog. Like, no. I'm
nigga,
not
you play tetherball.
It's good exercise, dog.
I'm about to say, hold on. When we get to shaming childhood sports.
First off, we never answered the question about top three shows. We got into this geriatric.
Nigga made a whole fucking episode.
We were.
That's
supposed to be a fucking segment, nigga.
Nah, this nigga, he conned us to get us in the door, nigga. He like, well, now that I got y'all here, what do you feel about Brittany Griner?
Oh, my goodness. Hey, did y'all hear this nigga take on Brittany? You know he'll fuck Brittany Griner, right?
I felt like it's another one.
What's her name?
Brittany Griner, though. Let's talk about how you said you would have sex with her.
I didn't say I would have.
Legitimate, though.
Yeah, she can get it. I said he showed a ghoul and he said if it was two people, Brittany Griner or a ghoul, who would I hit? I said Brittany Griner.
Then we morphed the conversation into Lizzo and you still said
conversation to Lizzo because we was on air. That's why you morphed the conversation and said Lizzo's name. But I
didn't
want to
be disrespectful.
I answered the question as if we were still talking about the person in hand. So don't try
Lizzo,
to be
funny. I'm asking you right now.
Harrison
Lizzo
is a fat
or Brittany Griner?
Regular Lizzo, like the actual Lizzo,
Lizzo
the person we talking about.
The real Lizzo, yes.
What other Lizzo is there?
Yeah,
Lizzo.
I was gonna say, nigga, what the fuck? I mean,
no, they know what I'm talking about. They use Lizzo as
no,
a cover.
No, I was talking about the real Lizzo.
No, you weren't talking about Lizzo.
Actual flute playing Lizzo.
Yes, yeah. That one.
No. So we all got it.
So Harrison. Goo with a real coochie or Brittany with she gonna hit you with what you got. That which one you taking?
I'm gonna tell her I got somewhere to be.
Nah, you gotta fuck one.
You gotta make a choice.
You gotta hit one, bro.
You gotta fuck one.
But the second part is a continuation of it. That's not a part of it.
Answer the question.
Goo with authentic coochie is real.
Brittany got one too, nigga. Why you keep acting like
Brittany
she got a.
Brittany got all her shit cut off. She be on IG naked.
Brittany got that V. She got hair around her navel in a V, nigga.
Nigga, yeah. She didn't cut off her vagina.
Yeah, she did. She donated her coochie lips to.
Yeah, nigga, she missing all type of arm skin right here, yeah, nigga, right. To make a shaft.
Yeah.
So anyway, like Barbie doll.
She only got nine fingers because she need a bone down there. She got nine fingers. All right,
nigga. So Kendall, what is the top three shows that you got?
Wire. So Brittany still. And Ozark.
Thank you. All right. Dolly, what you got?
Did I you already watch answer? TV, so it's fucked up, nigga. Like, you talking about drug related, nigga? I got motherfucking
any shows.
Any show?
Y'all know you. We got to help you out because you don't watch
any
shit.
Show. Yeah, nigga.
Nigga, I got Family Matters, The Fresh Prince.
Nigga, I got Snowfall, Chappelle Show, and The Boondocks.
God damn, boy.
Nigga, they ain't either. He named one show.
Nigga, I don't watch TV, nigga. Okay, motherfucker. Snowfall, BMF, and Power.
Keep it.
Since you want to keep it on drug shit.
Nah, nigga just named most three recent shows out. Man, what's
them the only ones I fucking watch, nigga.
That nigga looked at the last watch on Netflix and named what it was.
He's about to go through kid shit. What y'all watching?
Yeah, nigga, I don't watch TV.
Naruto, whatever that
nigga
is.
Said Coco Melon, One Punch Man.
And Dragon Ball Super. Goddamn.
Dragon Slayer, nigga. Demon Slayer.
But my son was watching that shit. So I think it's pretty cool.
Nigga said Demon Slayer, nigga.
Oh yeah, we can call a wrap right there. I got Snowfall. I mean, I got The Wire, Snowfall, and if we go on all shows, Martin. We doing drugs.
You wasn't even born when Martin was on TV.
Martin came out in 91. I said all.
Born in 90, motherfucker. You was watching Elmo, niggas. Don't put Martin on your list, young ass nigga.
Hey. All these niggas watch Martin on DVD.
We was around for the original.
Niggas was watching syndicated episodes of Martin.
If we talking drugs, you can read, and you talking about you was watching Martin. Come on, stop.
Nigga, you ain't got to read. You ain't got to read an audio show.
HBO. 4 years old. He was four when Martin ended, man.
Okay. Anyways, all right. So
DVD ass niggas.
So niggas watch Good Time.
That's like me saying Sanford and Son is my favorite show and shit, my nigga. Like, come on.
I mean.
Why it's got to be something you?
That's a hell of a show.
No.
It was a syndication when I was little, nigga. You know, it was reruns when I was.
So then we can't. So we can't even pick the Cosby Show because
that nigga Tonio looked like a character from Sanford, nigga. That nigga ain't seen a barber in at least 3 weeks.
He said you were like you.
That nigga part right here. That motherfucker Ben grew in. I'm like, this nigga Tonio ain't seen a barber in a long time. Your barber on vacation.
He said you like. He said you like looking.
Hey,
yeah,
that's it.
Buffalo butt, nigga. Where your barber at?
Hey, Dolly,
you knew you was gonna be on camera.
You said he got the Robert Harris part.
Yeah, huh?
Y'all would. You and Lamont were moving parts out there.
Nah, man. I told you, nigga. That shit was before my time.
You were great, grandson.
That shit was before my time. But I told you, you got grass stains on that T-shirt.
You said what?
You got grass stains on that T-shirt. You look like a maintenance man right now. A maintenance man.
Oh yeah, man. I can get everything done. I can get the air conditioner fixed in your room when you leave out.
And get tail.
Tall, you my brother, but you look like you ain't his daddy and you ain't happy.
Don't do it. Yeah,
you about to go get cured from that party. Hey, I told that boy to stop fucking up.
Hey, you and Harrison don't do it. See, I don't talk crazy to old people on Sundays because this day, this is the Lord's day. I don't mess with old people. But you young,
what's crazy? You the youngest one on the show right now.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
But you look like you the oldest.
You look like uncle. I know the youngest call you uncle.
I'm like they call me uncle.
You got uncle. They be like uncle.
But this shit right here.
What's up, OG?
That nigga barber has left the building.
That's crazy. He on the way to where yours went to.
Hairline on the way to where his went to.
Yeah,
nigga.
I'm gonna say, man, you better thank your lucky stars. Your shit's still right here, boy, because I'm bald for a reason. I had to let my shit go. I ain't even gonna bullshit you.
Let me live. I ain't 20.
You 25 with a 35-year-old hairline, nigga. That's what
I'm saying. Hey, Durham, I know is some shit under that mask right now.
Yeah, some gray shit.
Take that motherfucker off.
Some gray shit. That's about it, nigga. This shit gray, but it's there.
Only on live line holes telling him it's lint in his beard. Nah, it's gray shit.
Nah, nigga, but I'm proud of my gray, nigga. I'm telling you, dog. These bitches love gray beards, nigga. Y'all, you might want to dye your shit gray.
Yeah, man. Old bitches in the retirement home probably can't
man,
see
young,
that color line.
Young bitches love it.
They definitely love that shit.
Young bitches love it, dog.
They you know,
that sounds real predatory.
Hey, man. They think I'm going to be a sugar daddy.
You know, you keep them, them Alfredo warriors y'all got out there these days. I'm cool. Man. That's all they have.
Oh, my God.
That's crazy.
All right, Banks. So, before we wrap this, what's your list? Oh, my third one was Ozark. But what's your list?
Ozark.
That nigga had to remind us he was a blood.
Yeah, you see that, bro?
He had to remind us. He had to remind us he was a blood, nigga. He had to let his affiliation be known on his way out.
Do a three like this and shit.
Right. Yeah, nigga, that nigga was like, nigga.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, my third one and shit.
Oh, Lord. Who does a three? Do that what you just did.
He still
hell no, nah, nigga. You gonna try to fucking cut
does,
the clip?
Who does three
that's,
like
that's
that?
What three? That's what who I does, mean. Three?
Who
that's
does
how
that?
You learn three?
That's how you do three. One, two, three, four, five.
Hey, Jordan, that nigga been Big B since kindergarten.
Exactly, right? Nigga. That nigga's a blood.
That nigga threw it up righteously too.
He got the burgundy shirt on because he's from Piru.
He said, "You remember that?"
The Pyrus wear burgundy. He a Pyru.
Got a Phillies hat. Yeah.
Yeah. He had to throw that Pete phone business.
Yeah, that's crazy.
He said, "You remember that talk we had about blood and the Crips, man?"
Yeah.
Well, that nigga's blood.
That nigga's a blood.
Big Stacy.
Well, thanks for your top three, man.
What's your top three, Banks?
Man, I'm gonna go with Snowfall, Narcos, and Ozark with an honorable mention of Top Boy.
Top Boy decent.
Pause.
It's like The Wire in England.
Pause. Right. It's a lot of bruv and internet and
bruv in it. The rose man. Man. Where's my peas, bro? Where's my peas, bro? You need food, bro. You got the food, bro. You want Duchesne. Peace. Where's Scully at, Duchesne?
Did everybody got their list?
Did Tony have a
list? No, I ain't go. Journal go neither.
Okay.
He did.
He said Soprano, Barney, Blues Clues.
No, you remember said All in the Family, Green Acres, and Golden Girls.
I'm going The Wire. I'm going Snowfall, and then I'm going Power.
Love and Marriage, honorable mention.
What the fuck is Love and Marriage?
What the fuck is that?
What the
called Married with Children. What the fuck? I'm like, I ain't never heard of that. This nigga got that shit on Channel 3 local TV or some shit.
Real quick question.
Original cable box area.
I got one question for y'all. Better shoe salesman in Chicago, Michael Jordan or Al Bundy?
Michael Jordan.
Al Bundy.
The greatest shoe salesman of all time. That's Michael Jordan's whole legacy outside of basketball is selling shoes.
Al Bundy, bro.
I go Bundy. Yeah.
How is it that Al Bundy was trying not to fuck Peg Big Sexy Ass?
Because he was married to her for long and she
stole been wearing
his,
Peg ass out.
She stole his life from him. Like Al was a damn all-state football player, scored 4 touchdowns in 1 game. Like, you know what I'm saying? And he got with Peggy Wanker. You know what I'm saying? She was from another town and she just took his life, so he ain't want to fuck her no more, man. Like,
damn, nigga, you got all that from the intro?
He should have been cheating.
Bro, Married with Children is one of the GOAT shows. Like, he one of my favorite TV dads out there, nigga. Like, don't do it.
Cheating saves marriages, dog. He should have cheated.
This how you know. I just watch in and out of episodes.
Pause.
I just watch episodes periodically of Married with Children. I ain't know none of that shit.
So you don't know nothing about the No Ma'am Club or nothing like that?
Nope. I know he sold shoes. I know he
had a fine daughter.
I know that that neighbor got married twice or whatever.
Marcy.
And I know that they adopted a little kid.
She was married to Steve first, then she got married to Jefferson. Jefferson Darcy.
So I don't even that was a cold upgrade.
Talking about Jefferson?
Yeah, Jefferson was a cold idiot, but
yeah, hey, he ain't working nothing. Steve, at least Steve had a job. Jefferson, he was a freeloader. He took
he was a boy toy.
Yeah.
She obviously had that money. Yeah, thank you.
So we can let's see. Shoot, I think that's where we'll wrap it up here. Appreciate all my guests, Banks, Dolly, King Germ. We appreciate y'all coming out. Snowfall, another great show. It's way better than Breaking Bad, which was don't resonate with real black people. But hopefully y'all can come back and join us again. We hope
Harrison
bang.
Honestly, I think I can fuck with a motherfucker like you.
Gucci.
See, I don't like a motherfucker that be all on this.
It's the 81 and 92 podcast, where we always keep it 100.
Don't be one.
You know how we do.
Me 100.
Gucci.